In my Ozark Studies class, I have been assigned to do a project on someone who has served our community. I have chosen to write my paper on Mary Elizabeth Mankey. Mary Elizabeth served the community in so many ways. For this research project, I have interviewed a distant relative of Miss Mankey, one Miss Liz Turner. Mrs. Turner is Mrs. Mankey's distant granddaughter. Mrs. Mankey was born August 16, 1877, in a little town called Harrison, Arkansas. She and her family moved quite a bit throughout her youth. Mrs. Mankey did not attend school. She stayed home and learned everything she knows from her parents and her older brother. Her parents were pretty smart people and were successful in their careers. Mrs. Mankey had started becoming interested in writing and poetry. When she was 14 years old, Mrs. Mankey took over her father's newspaper article. Every week for the rest of her life, up until 2 weeks before she passed away, Mrs. Mankey wrote in the weekly newspaper. Mrs. Mankey's father, Mr. Mankey, was one of the original Bald Knobbers. He then became part of the government for a while, then he helped shut down the Bald Knobbers group due to things that were being done that were against the rules. He was also a postmaster. Press Mankey and Mrs. Mankey, known as Mary Elizabeth Bradford at the time, met when they were 13 years old. When she was 21 and he was 23, Mrs. Bradford at the time and Press Mankey got married January 18, 1899. Mrs. Mankey and her husband had four kids, two of which she lost at early ages. Mrs. Mankey lost one of her kids at an early age in their lives due to flooding in a tornado. The other passed away at birth. Mrs. Mankey became interested in poetry and writing at a very young age. When she was little, she started writing in a journal. She had so many of them. As I said before, when she was 14 years old, she took over her father's weekly newspaper article and wrote in it for 57 years. 2 weeks before she died was her last time writing in that newspaper. Mrs. Mankey is very well known for her poetry. Poetry is her passion. She spent a very good amount of time writing it. From all this time Mrs. Mankey spent on her writing and her poetry, she has contributed her time. She didn't have to take her time to do this. She could have chosen to do something much more, but writing was what she enjoyed, so that is what she pursued. Since she enjoyed writing so much, she went to schools and became a teacher to teach it. She attended normal school and earned her degree in teaching at age 16. At age 17, she received her first job as a teacher in Springfield, Missouri, earning $20 a month. After a while, she got tired of teaching because she got homesick and decided to move back home to Taney County to be with her family, where she spent the rest of her life. Throughout her married life, Mrs. Mankey had different jobs. She was a postmaster, farmer, and even a storekeeper. However, no matter what job she had, she always kept writing. She kept many journals and wrote for several magazines and published many volumes of poetry. Mrs. Mankey also spoke for the women. She was not afraid to speak her mind. Then are just some of the things that Mary Elizabeth Mankey did to serve her community.